Be greeted in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We greet everyone and everyone who's watching us live. My name is Thembela Ntila. I am saved. I love the Lord. Today we're going to be sharing the word of God in the book of Joshua, chapter number 1, verse number 8. This book it read as follows. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous and you will have a good success. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless the reading of your word. In Jesus' name, amen. I want us today to speak about the power of meditation on scriptures. First of all, what is meditation? I believe meditation, it is an art of reasoning through the scriptures. Whenever you study the word of God, whenever you think, whenever you ponder, whenever you consider the word of God, and that is meditation. I want us to carefully look at this verse. Remember, this is the book of Joshua, whereby God was instructing Joshua, now that my servant Moses has departed, what is it that you must do, my son Joshua, in order for you to fill the position of Moses? Then God said some words in this man of God called Joshua. He said, Joshua, I am giving you this command. What is going to help you in your life, in your ministry, in your everything? Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Remember, this is a command. God was not suggesting to Joshua that Joshua, at some times you may leave this book. But he was saying, Joshua, in order for you to be like Moses, in order for you to feel the shoes of Moses, in order for you to lead Israel, one command I am giving you. Number one, do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Number two, meditate on it day and night, so that you may be able to observe, to do according to what is written. So meditate on it, think upon it, ponder on it. Eligama le kutwa meditate from Hebrew is the name kutwa, that name is Hagar. The name Hagar means to think upon something. The name Hagar means to speak something out. The name Hagar means to ponder, lento. Now, for you, Joshua, to go with my people, take my law, take my word, meditate on it. Because in meditation, it gives wisdom. In meditation, it makes you to be able to, when you reason through scriptures, you will get wisdom, a wisdom that is from the scriptures. So I'm here to encourage believers in such a time that you are living in. One of the things that is so powerful in our time that will help us as saints, as believers everywhere, we must not neglect an art of meditation, meditating through scriptures. Because when you meditate on scriptures, when you think upon scriptures, you will know what to say. Goba uti, do not let it depart from your mouth, but meditate on it day and night. Uti, so that you may be able to observe, to do according to what is written. Uti, then you will make your way prosperous and you will have a good success. Akatangu tiko, I will make your way. Uti, when Joshua, you meditate on my word, when Joshua, you think upon my word, I will make your way prosperous. Remember, the book of Psalms says, Psalms chapter 1, it says, blessed is everyone. It ay uyololomntu ongahambiyo ngecebo labangendawo ongemiyo endleleni yaboni ongahlaliyo embuthweni yabagxeki. Uthi verse 2, but he meditates in the law of the Lord day and night, or he delights in the law of the Lord day and night. Ithi ke ngoku xa seyidlula, ithi umntu onjalo, he shall be like a tree that is planted by the streams of waters. This Bible is continuing to declare that umntu onjalo, who meditates in the book of the law. Now, I like a description, this book of someone, it says that person who meditates in the law of the Lord, who keeps the word of God in the heart, who speaks the word of God outside. But if you are doing that, he's giving you a name that when you shall be like a tree that is planted by the streams of waters, whose leaf does not wither, but you give fruit in every season. In other words, when you keep the word of God in you, when you speak the word of God, when you think upon the word of God, many things will not affect you in your life. So I am here to revive an art of meditating on scriptures. Let us not just read the word of God and pass by, because there are many treasures that are stored upon the word of God. Many things you can speak them to pass simply because you have meditated in the law of the Lord. Remember, the Bible 18. Now, what about Joshua? What Joshua, do not let it depart from your mouth. The Bible 18. At the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. In other words, when your heart is full of the word, you will be able to speak the word of God. You will be able to command things to happen. You will be able to speak his indozenzeg. You must know what, for the word of God to come out of your mouth, it starts within your heart. Your heart must store the word. Your heart must keep the word. We need people in such times as this. Even if we go through a lot of challenges, a lot of things, there is something that I know that will never lose its power. It is the word of God when it's kept upon you. Every man of God, every woman of God that was used by God, those people, they have kept the word of God in their hearts after meditating through the scriptures. Because remember, through the scriptures you get the wisdom of God, you get an understanding, you become enlightened into so many things of the word of God. There is no man who can be used by God or be used thoroughly and know the things of God, a man who never meditated on the word of God. Izwilengosi put it clearly, because that in meditation, it's so powerful. Lento, it has helped the life of this young man Joshua. For Joshua to stand, for Joshua to lead Israel, it was a must for him to store the word of God. After storing the word of God, you speak it out. Speak on your life. Speak on your condition. Like they say, in the name of Jesus, I declare and decree whatever that attacks your mind. When the word is in the heart, you will be able to speak it out to your challenges, to your families, to your circumstances, to even the things that we go through. It might happen that you are looking for the job and currently you are not getting a job, but you have got something which is so powerful. Keep on speaking the word of God. Keep on meditating on the promises of God. Keep on keeping the Izulenkos. Keep on at the all time. Let it run through your mouth, run through your mind, run through your heart. When you are keeping the word of God, it will make you to be a better person. Do you want to be better? Speak the word. Do you want to be better? Keep the word in the mind at all times. Even if things are not changing, but keep on speaking the word of God. Remember, the word of God says, when the clouds be full, the rain will come out. It might happen the condition you start to go through, you are still filling up the clouds, and when the clouds are full, the rain will come. So I'm here to encourage you on the word of God. Keep the word of God. Speak the word of God in every condition. It might happen that you are sick. You say, in the name of Jesus, I declare and decree, I am healed. In the name of Jesus, I am prosperous. In the name of Jesus, I am this. I'm here to encourage every young person, every person who is living on this earth, everyone in South Africa, everyone who's watching this, in the name of Jesus Christ, your life will never be the same. When you meditate and keep the scriptures, this thing of meditation and keeping the scriptures is an art that is powerful to take you places. In the name of Jesus, declare and speak the word of God, and your life will change. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless the reading of your word. In the name of Jesus, bless everyone who is watching us. Bless everyone who is keeping your word. Bless everyone to have a capacity and ability to keep and store your word. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.